Hi there and welcome to Vidwanza. Thank you so much for joining me today. I am so happy to have you and I'm very excited as I'll be sharing another home decor video with you today. If you have not subscribed to my channel, please make sure that you subscribe because this is where I share about something that I love so much, interior decor. And I am excited to be sharing my ideas and I don't know, just about home decor with you guys. And today we are talking about mirrors, decorative mirrors, okay? You can use decorative mirrors in your space to promote home decor. Is it to promote or to enhance home decor in your space at home? And so today, as you're talking about decorative mirrors, I just want to highlight a few things before I show you the different ways that you can, you know, use decorative mirrors in your space. And the few things I've mentioned is that one, you need to consider the type of decorative mirrors that you're putting in your space in terms of their sizes. Decorative mirrors come in different sizes. You have small sizes, you have medium, and then you have big ones. Even big that can fill a wall, you know, like the entire wall can be covered in a mirror, which of course can be decorated to look more, you know, more appealing. And then you want to consider the other aesthetics in your living space or in your your decorative space. That means consider things like color, consider things like space, the size of your space, so that when you're choosing a mirror, you're not choosing a mirror that is either too big or too small for your space, or a mirror that is actually clashing with other decorative items in your space. So that's something else that you want to consider. The other thing is buy something that you love, okay? Something that you look at and you like. And then the other thing that I can say is that you can consider using a set of mirrors or one mirror, depending on what you want to achieve. And then there are different places where you can use your mirrors. You can use them in your living space, you can use them in your bedroom, you can use them on the corridor, you can use them in the bathroom. There are different places that you can use decorative mirrors. And the other thing about mirrors is that you can choose to add unique decor to it, and I'll be showing you images of what I mean by that. So it doesn't have to be boring, and you also want to consider the types of frames that you want. Do you want something simple, or do you want something a bit more shouting and appealing and, you know, making a statement? So you have to think about all that, and I'll be showing you that in the, you know, just right now in the images that you're going to be viewing together, which are amazing. Okay, so let's get straight into, you know, seeing the images. Ah, look at this first one, guys. I think this is one of my favorites. I like the design. Can you see the design? The design is amazing. The other thing that you have to consider when buying mirrors is where you place them. If you have, for example, kids in your house, you want to make sure that if you're gonna have mirrors, then you have placed them in spaces where kids will not be at risk, or rather the mirrors will not be easily accessible by kids, because we know that mirrors are very delicate and they can easily be broken. So when you look at this one is making a statement, to be honest, and I think it is one of my favorites. I like the design. It's one mirror, but the design is very, very unique. And can you see the guys, the thing about colors? This person has, you know, the mirror has gray framing, and which goes very well with sofas in the space and the other decor stuff, as you can see, like the curtains. So that is something that you want to consider. The other mirror, can you see when you're talking about different patterns? I like this pattern, and it's quite unique. Not very shouting, but also not very simple. I think it's an amazing, unique design, and you can see where it's placed. That looks like I don't know whether it's a console table. It looks like it's on, I'm not sure whether it's on the sitting room or it's on the corridor. I can't tell, but it looks very good. And can you see the complementing details for the other decor stuff in the space? It looks amazing. All right. The next image, this is what you're calling a set of mirrors, guys. And can you see the decorative details on the set of mirrors? It looks very classic, I think, and it looks very beautiful in the space. Again, not too loud, but making a statement, but in such an appealing way. I think this is also one of my best mirrors. I like it. And Can you see the frames? The frames are not, they are quite simple, but they come out very, very well. The other mirror is placed on the floor, as you can see, and this is the other way that you can place a mirror on the floor. You know, the other reason that we use mirrors, apart from them being a decorative thing, is also to add natural lighting to the space or to create an illusion for more space. And can you see the one on the placed on the floor? I guess it can create that illusion, but I'll show you a better one that creates that illusion. I like the complementing detail of the plant and the vase or vase that is on the other side. I think they look so good together. And now this is an example of decorative mirrors in the washroom, for example. And you can see there are two. They look alike. They are very simple, but they are very appealing. They look so good. Yes, another example of a mirror placed on the floor. So there are different places you can place a mirror: on the console table, on the wall, or on the floor. There are different places. So those are just examples. Look at this one, guys. I just like the way it is, so simple, and plus you have that big mirror and then the two small complementing mirrors, and they're placed on the wall, and that looks like a console table, if I'm not wrong. And I think they are simple and beautiful. So this goes well for people who are minimalist, who don't like things that are shouting all over. And now there's this other one. This one is on the, yeah, we can see that's a console table, and again a simple mirror on the wall with a very simple frame and very nice complementing things to just, you know, bring it to life. And this one is in the sitting room, as you can see. So it's creating an illusion of more space, I guess. And probably it's also, you know, playing to add more light in the space. This one again is placed on the floor in the bedroom. So this is another space where you can use these mirrors. In the bedroom, it's quite big, and I like that it complements the space. Very simple, but complementing the space very, very well. This is the example of the decorative mirrors that I was saying, where you can actually come up with patterns and designs. This is a design for a flower mirror, and it's done so, so well. I think it's an excellent job. Simple, but quite elegant. I like it. Here is another example of mirrors that are turned into designs. Quite simple, but also looking very, very good. I like the complementing aspect of the flowers and the tray on the table. They look very good together. Look at this mirror. It's big. It's on the wall. It's in the sitting room. And I think it's such a good piece to add in the decorative space. I like the framing. It's a bit different from the ones that we've been seeing. It's a beautiful mirror. This one again is placed on the console table. Again, this goes well, very well for minimalists, people who don't like a lot of stuff. As you can see, there's not a lot of stuff or a lot of things going on there. Simple mirror, simple living space, but elegant and beautiful. This one has details, you know, decorative details. It's still one placed on a console table, but it looks beautiful. I like the black wall frame, okay? This one is in the bedroom again. Can you see? It's a very simple mirror. The frames are brown, and I like how they look. But then the mirror is divided into squares on the inside. So that's another simple decorative ways that you can do mirrors in your space. And this one is placed in the bedroom just on the headboard. And it looks amazing. I think it's complementing the space. I like the green on the wall. Yes, and this one is on this in the sitting room. It's quite big again. It's creating an illusion of more space, I guess. And I like how they have placed the plant in front of the mirror. I think that's a beauty, that's a decor thing that this person has come up with in this particular image that you're looking at. And I think it looks very, very beautiful. It's bringing an element of the space being a bit busy in a good way. Again, another simple mirror on the wall, placed just below up the console table. Again, with the complementing details, they are looking very nice. I think this is one of my best mirrors that is on the wall, placed just above the console table. Very simple, but standing out in a very in a way that can be seen, but it's still very simple. I like the size. I think for me, I prefer a size that is bigger, like this one. It's not too big, yet it's not quite small. It's just big enough, and that's what I would want for myself. I think I really like how it looks. I hope that you have enjoyed this video and that you've gotten ideas on how you can use decorative mirrors in your space. Thank you so much for watching the video. Please make sure that you subscribe if you have not. I look forward to seeing you in my next video.